Yeah.
Oh. Oh, big boy. What a big standard. Riddle. Good morning, everyone. I hope you're doing fantastic today. We have something kind of fun to start the day off with today. We have been organizing all of our new shelves and pullouts and cabinets, and while we were doing that, we found something that we had ordered a while ago. We meant to eat it and talk about it at the time, but we haven't, and we still have it, and I thought we'd try it out today. It's this here, illegal chips. So these have some connection with Rhett and Link. I believe it's their company, Mythical Kitchen. These are chips in the flavor of illegal things, such as horse meat flavored. Horse meat. Kazu Marzu, which is also lovingly referred to as maggot cheese. And finally, we have fugu, which is a type of like puffer fish, and it's extremely poisonous. The horse meat and the puffer fish one are actually vegan, and then the katsu marzu, which is the maggot cheese, obviously, I think it's got some cheese flavor in it, so it is vegetarian.
I like this one.
You want me to try this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Smells like potato chips.
That smells like puffer fishes.
Puffer fishes. So it doesn't taste bad. It doesn't taste like fish though. Like it doesn't taste like a fish flavoring. Duncan wants to try it.
It tastes like something I've had before, but not right.
It's a meat. That's all I taste, it's meat.
You taste meat?
And salt and vinegar.
I like that. That's like, probably gonna be my favorite one out of these.
Really good. You did a whole bag?
Yeah. I don't really know how to explain that though. There is sort of a meaty sort of sweet taste.
Tastes like steak.
Steak?
Yeah.
What? I did not taste that.
Yeah, I didn't get steak at all.
Well, that's what it was. It was Mongolian beef.
Mongolian beef?
Yeah. What are you talking about? I did not taste steak.
Which one do you want to try next, Jake?
I think this horse one.
Horse meat.
If I try this and I like it, I'm gonna feel really guilty.
I don't like that face, Dad.
It reminds me of the ketchup chips that we had in Canada. Just a little bit. Just a little bit of that flavoring. Get a little whiff.
It's a
or is
weird.
It's weird, right?
That actually smells like our vitamins. It's like really sweet.
It's sweet?
Sweet at first. Yeah, that is ketchup. I would eat more.
I've had this. I've had something like this.
It reminds me of like peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
It tastes like something I've had before.
I know it.
It tastes like cardboard mixed with dog food, mixed with streamers, mixed with a little bit of salt.
The last one is Kazu Marzu, which is based on an actual cheese that they ferment by allowing flies to lay eggs in it, and they encourage maggots to eat and digest the cheese to give it a very unique flavor. It is illegal. Ooh, gotta smell.
Mm. Ew.
Yeah.
Wait, it smells like raw cheese.
Okay, it tastes kind of like a cheddar cheese flavored chip with like a little extra.
cheddar cheese flavored chips. It just tastes like a potato chip.
Just like regular
a
old?
Sprinkle of cheddar cheese flavoring.
Oh my gosh. I do not like cheese flavored like chips or popcorn.
Wait. There's a little aftertaste of like mealworms.
You are me.
Like, what's it called? The green onion?
Oh, like chives?
Chives and...
Sour cream?
Sour cream, yeah.
Ah, yes, sour cream. Like a cheese with some sour cream?
Yep.
Tastes like a regular chip.
Do you like it?
Really?
Yeah? So, Luke was at the park. Do you want to try some chips?
Chips,
okay. So this is the poison blowfish flavor.
More.
You like that one? You like that one? It's supposed to taste like a fish. That fish right there. Does it taste like a fish? Do you want to try a different flavor? Different one? A different flavor? Okay, let's see if you can guess what flavor this one is. Do you like that one?
Mm-hmm. She likes all of them.
More? You want more of that? What's on the bag?
Me!
Yeah. Did it taste like a horse?
Horse.
It tasted like horse?
Oh, I know what he's gonna say.
What does that taste like? Mm. What does it taste like?
Snails.
Snails?
Yes.
Did you say snails?
Yeah.
It tastes like snails?
Wait, yes. Has he had a snail before?
No.
Snails are so yummy. They're so good.
I love snails.
I love escargot.
You want more? Okay, this one is supposed to taste like cheese with little worms in it.
Cheese.
You see the little worms?
Cheese.
Yeah. Would you eat a worm?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. You have a yellow one, a red one, and a blue one. You tried all three flavors. Which one do you want more of?
Fish.
The yellow one? Oh, all of them. You want all of them.
You enjoying your chips?
Yeah.
And I wanted to give you guys a little update on the house because we did rearrange the furniture a little bit in the fireplace area. So let me have you check it out over here. Oh, I'll back up first. Okay, so this is what it's looking like now. Somebody actually commented to add one of these cabinets here, and we did it. So that was not my idea at all. I don't know why it didn't even occur to me. And I do like the couch this direction, like just in general, because I like being cozy and like warming up by the fire. So I like this idea, but Christopher's kind of like in general on the fence about it because there's this walkway to outside and he just doesn't want it to be too tight. I don't think it is too tight. Like, I think it's fine. Feeling that out, I like it like this. We were just gonna sell or donate the extra cabinet. So I was like, let's try it out. Let's see how it feels before we get rid of it. And the big change in here was that we got a rug, and I think I like it, but I wanna hear what you guys think. And the one regret I have is that I feel like, I think I got a 9x6 because I was trying it out in the kitchen, didn't work, but that's what fits in the kitchen. And I think this should probably be an 8x10, so it's like, nah, just a little bit bigger. I don't know, it feels silly, like maybe it doesn't matter, but I think technically it should have been that way. I don't know, I'm not really good with rugs. I just read things and that's kind of what it tells me. So tell me what you think. It's busy in here right now. We've got Rue's toys and Parker left his shoes, and Rue's crate is now out here because we're using the office as a bedroom. Oh, and Christopher has his little record player. What a fancy. And this side is gonna have some sort of foliage, but I don't have it yet. And then this is actually not gonna be here. And I'm hoping to do something really cool up here, but I don't know what yet. So this is the rug, and I think it's just so cool. It just adds a richness to this room. So you can kind of get an idea. This is like, I love this space, but it is kind of like a an oddly like compacted space. We have to be really intentional with it. I think we've tried a bunch of different things throughout our time living here. And then the other thing about it is it has to transform into our Christmas space because this is where the fireplace is. We like to have the fireplace with the stockings and like that whole feel next to the Christmas tree. And Ruth's crate will probably be in here for a little bit, but like that's not a big deal to us. I also don't know, like as she gets older, how long we'll have the crate for. I know that we wanna have it for at least her first 2 years, and then I think she'll want it. She does like it. She spends like her rest time in there, and it's her safe space. We have so many people in this family and so many small children that it's nice for her to be able to have a separate space that she can go to. I don't know, but it doesn't bother me out here. I think ultimately people can move it to different places, but we'll see. Maybe I should get like a cute one and then it can match the fireplace room, but I feel like that would be down the line.
Look at these buddies.
I like having the rug in here a lot.
You do like it.
Well, yeah, last night, it didn't even occur to me that it was because of the rug, but like last night you and I were like sitting here just having a conversation with while like cuddling Rue. Like we're just here, just hanging out.
She's such a cuddle bug.
I really like it. It feels cozy. I kind of like the space feeling small in here. Like back there, yeah. It looks so like big and tall, yes, and open.
Yeah.
And to have like a little place where you can sort of like get away and like have a conversation one-on-one or like sit next to each other cuddling by the fire, like that's cool. Yeah. Not that we're having many fires right now because it's hot.
I know, I can't wait.
When it's cold, we'll set up the fireplace and we'll just like chill out in here. It'll be nice.
And how are you, Jacob? I did happen to show your foot here. Do you want to talk about what happened?
So I broke my toe. So I did gymnastics for a pretty long time. And then COVID happened and I had to stop. And we started going back, but I couldn't go because I had broken my wrist. Yesterday was the first day that I felt like my wrist had enough strength. So within the first hour, I broke my toe. But the doctor did say it would heal pretty quickly and he gave me this shoe here.
So this is what it looks like right now. I think it's very cute. We could add some stuff up there and we could also put some stuff up here. We used to have family photos. I think we want to go back to that, but I don't know for sure. And then I do need to buy, like, I want to get like a pretty plant for right in that zone. But I like it. I think it's warm and cozy and inviting, and it's a good space for little Rue. You want to go outside? Okay, let's go.
Hello. So my mouth still tastes like fish. That's fun. It also has the aftertaste of the horse. Other than that, so a lot of people have been asking me about school and how it's been, and so far I don't really know if I want to talk about it yet until I've finished at least 1 week of actual school. I've mostly been doing orientation, but yeah, I've been having fun. It's very new to me. Some of it I don't like, some of it I like. I'm really enjoying the experience with right now. Well, I just kind of was in a band camp for like one day just now. It was really fun. I learned how to play the marimba. I think that's how you pronounce it. Marimba? I don't know. But I learned how to play it, so I can play that now. I feel like every instrument's pretty easy once you learn piano. Yeah, I've been doing theater. That's been fun. I've really been enjoying that. We haven't gotten to the school part yet. I did an orientation thing with my academy, which is a lot of theater, a lot of performing arts. That's what I've been doing. It's been fun. Bye.
Okay, we're about to whip up a snack in the air fryer. And I do have to say, I know we are so late to this air fryer trend. So I feel like everybody out there has an air fryer and they're like, yeah, this is what you make in it. You guys, come on.
But we appreciate.
We do appreciate it, and we're getting a lot of great recipe ideas and things from you guys, so thank you so much. I did see one person comment that they were like, okay, do I need an air fryer? Which is like, obviously how I've been feeling for the past couple years, especially since we're a large family, and I've heard that air fryers are large,
but their like basket is small. So that was one thing that I always thought kind of ruled us out, because I was like, I'm not gonna make like 3 french fries for all of us and like take up that footprint with this new gadget. I'm not gonna do that. I'm not falling for this. However, we did end up getting like a large air fryer. I don't know, it does take up a big footprint. It was not in the original kitchen remodel plan. So this is the all cool. Obviously it's like, I think it's some sort of Amazon knockoff brand of something, but it was kind of cute and matched our kitchen. So I was like, yes, all cool, here we go. I don't know the size, but I do know that it was like the large one. There was this all cool listing on Amazon, and they had a bunch of different sizes, and this one was large, and a lot of people were talking about how it was large, and I was like, yes, that's the one that would work for us. And the basket looks like this. I have this Nalgene water bottle right here. So this is like an idea of how large it is. Sorry, I don't have measurements. That's how I do things. But I have to say, like, as far as unnecessary kitchen gadgets go, this one is like used all the time. Like we're just always using it. And I really did think that we were gonna get it and we were gonna be like, okay, like it's an Instapot, or like, okay, it's the slow cooker but fast, or something, you know what I mean? Or like, oh, it's frying things, and like we don't really fry things, because we don't. Like, I've never had a deep fryer machine, and you know, at the fair when they have deep fried stuff, I'm kind of like, all right, I'll try it for the novelty once, but like, I don't really get it. I am not like wild for fried items, like I know some people are. So I was like, this seems really unnecessary, but actually we kind of use it for everything now. Like, we're genuinely using it almost 2 to 3 meals a day plus snacks, and like it's been really, really helpful. And it does seem pretty healthy, because we're not adding much to it when we're cooking. So Christopher's whipping up some sweet potato chips right now. And I'll let him explain that to you.
I'm just gonna toss these in some olive oil and then put them in here and run it on the fry setting. And I just sort of eyeball it. Like, if it looks done, then I taste one. And if it tastes done, then I'm done. And I'll season it. That's it. And yes, I do know that I'm crowding the basket. I'm a basket crowder, it's okay. I take it out and shake it every once in a while, and that seems to still work. The alternative is doing a bunch of batches, and with as many people as we have in our family, that just doesn't work, so shaking the basket every once in a while is the way to go. All right, so I cooked them exactly like I like my chips.
Charcoal.
Sweet potato chips are tricky. I haven't mastered them yet in here. They usually end up either floppy or this. I mean, it's got the crunch.
I kind of
like the birdie flavor. I'm fine with it. It's good. I'm gonna count this as a success. I couldn't grab the camera fast enough, but Teddy was standing up all by himself over here. He had pulled himself to a stand on the like a crate thing that we had for storage that we had gotten out, and he stood up and was just standing there, like, by himself.
For a long time.
For a long time.
Like, at least 10 seconds.
So, I'm gonna see if he'll stand up again, but he probably won't, but we'll try.
He did it for Rue. He was trying to give her that cookie, and she walked away, and he was just standing there. It's so funny. Oh, you wanna play with Rue?
Are you standing? Oh, hi Rue. Hello.
He's like, I'm standing. Is he doing it?
Let's see. Good job, Teddy.
Whoa.
Oh. Yeah, it's kind of tricky. Almost. Big boy.
Whoa.
Duncan, please don't stand in front of the camera.
Sorry.
Yeah. Oh,
big boy. What a big standard.
Rue. Rue.
Oh. Good job, Teddy.
He's ready. He's like,
oh.
Yeah, dance about it.
Whoa, very graceful.